Gore's the country music capital of New Zealand, the brown trout capital, and now aiming to be the fashion capital of Aotearoa. Its fashion design awards are the longest running in the country.
From humble beginnings, the Hokonui Fashion Awards are now a highly respected part of the domestic fashion scene. Julian Lee reports.
London, Milan, New York, Paris, Gore.
Go out there with your big smiles, with heaps of attitude, with happiness. Think about all the good things that you've done to get us to this point. You all look absolutely beautiful.
Well, we've got country, we've got cheese rolls, now we've got fashion.
Just knowing that you look sensational, that you are strong, you know what you're doing.
Have a great time and thank you so much for all your commitment.
The likes of Karen Walker and Trelease Cooper have been judges here. And it all started with a group of rural women showing off their knitwear.
So this is the 32nd show, and it started here in Gore by a woman called Biddy Kerr, who wanted to promote her wool. She used to do lots of knitting, and the local radio station picked it up and ran with it, and then progressively over the years people have become involved.
Oh, it's bizarre, isn't it? Because at times it doesn't get a great rap, but I mean, the people I know from Gore are fantastic people, you know what I mean? It's the standard of this whole production is world class, and I mean, people have just got to see it for themselves and believe it.
So yeah, it's quite exciting to be a part of.
I just think it'll be a really good experience, gain some confidence.
This is the only amateur competition where someone can enter and the judges or the general public like what they're doing, and that gives them a stepping stone up, and they can go on to design schools, they go on and work for designers.
The Saturday night show sold out in just 3 hours.
Year after year, it's just exceptional designs, exceptional models, and the talent from all of the volunteers that work behind the scenes, I think, are what make this event very special for Gore.
Yeah, they look really good on stage, yeah.
Yeah, pretty cool seeing them all up there on the runway. Yeah.
Gore, what do you reckon of Gore?
It's not too bad. It's quite similar to Marston and like around that area. It's small.
Yeah.
So it really brings out New Zealand culture.
And for a town of less than 13,000, Gore produces a disproportionate amount of New Zealand culture.
Well, we all had like garments to put into the show, and we actually did quite well. We had 2 second place, a first place, and then a couple of highly commended.
There's so much talent in this part of the country that it's just, yeah, I think these people just get together. They get together, they know how to have a good time, and, you know, the standard of the awards is just so high.
I just think we're good people in Gore.
It's different to other towns.
I think just because we're such a tight-knit community that everyone just rallies and gets in and gets the work done.
People don't believe that it could happen in Gore. Why should we come to Gore? Gore is a wonderful place. It couldn't happen anywhere else in the country.
A tightly woven community with a single-mindedness of purpose which gets results. Truly, a rising star of provincial New Zealand.
Absolutely. It's just going from strength to strength, isn't it? Gore, of course, was the gay capital, then the country and western capital, the brown trout capital, now the fashion capital.
There were some great outfits there.